You're listening to Gigi Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph. Hey girls, happy Monday!
It's Esther here with Steph, and I can't believe a month has already gone by.
That is fast.
So we hope, girls, that you've actually had time to catch up on all the episodes because they have been pretty good.
I've actually really enjoyed yeah. These ones too. I love the stories.
They are.
Plus, we have our Gigi Notes coming out this Friday.
Yes, so at the end of this week, you'll get a list of all the episodes we've played.
So make sure you've signed up in case you haven't, and also recapping our verse. So girls, if we go to Proverbs 12:19, it says, "Truthful lips endure forever, but a lying tongue lasts only a moment."
Yes. And also get ready because next week, Monday next week, we're actually going to start with Aiden and Evelyn.
How exciting.
It's a really good, you need to stay tuned in because we're going to give you a little bit of background of who these stories are about.
Definitely.
All right. So we also have a question today.
Oh, let's get into our question.
So the question says, "Hi Gigi, I need your help. I keep getting bullied at school by a guy in my grade. He sometimes pulls my hair, calls me names, or just says mean things to me. I sometimes hide in the toilet and cry. I don't know what to do."
So Sharon Witt actually wrote a great article for Gigi on what to do if you are being bullied. So the first thing is to seek help as soon as possible. You know, never give up, even if you don't get the assistance you need first. So keep asking for help until someone listens, whether it's a parent, a friend, or a teacher. Say no. As soon as you say this single powerful word, you're letting the bully know out loud in a clear way that doing or saying something is not okay. Also, stand tall and show confidence. Sometimes a bully is just someone who lacks confidence in themselves. They try to make others feel inferior to hide their own insecurities. Now, this is very hard, but it's something that you need to do. Even if you don't feel it, act confident and let the bully know they don't have power over you. And never look the other way. So if you see someone else being bullied, you owe it to others to let someone know who can help them. So a wonderful verse in the Bible says, "For I am the Lord your God who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you." Isaiah 41:13.
Those are such great advice from Sharon Witt. I really like them. And that verse, it's one of my favorites. Yes. So girls, it's important that if you're going through this, you need to seek help straight away and don't suffer in silence.
It's not easy being bullied and it's not okay.
No. All right, so let's get back into our devotional for today. We are continuing with our lips to love.
The widow of Nain. She's completely alone. She is heartbroken. She's about to go and bury her very last family member. This is not only painful, but she realizes that her life is about to change for the worse. She has no money, no income, no rights, and her livelihood that depends solely on a male relative has disappeared. She slowly but gracefully tries to compose herself and is grateful for the life she was able to have before now. She can hear the mourners crying and wailing outside her small, humble dwelling. How long would she be able to keep her little home? She wipes her tears as they begin falling rapidly down her face again. She hasn't stopped crying since her only son had died. She sinks on the old wooden chair next to her son's bed and sobs into her hands. She remembers a similar scenario some years ago when her husband passed away, but she also remembers the comfort of her precious son as she wept. He had promised her that day that he would take care of her always. He had always been such a good boy. But now he was gone too. A gentle knock at the door reminded her it was time. Slowly getting up, she made her way to the door and opened it to let the men in. It was time to bury her son. She would never see his smiling face again or hear his sweet voice asking if she needed anything. She would never hold her grandchildren and teach his wife his favorite dishes. She had nothing anymore. The men carry his cold, still body, and she follows slowly behind them, her tears and soft sobs mingling with the other women. The large city gate looms ahead, and she knows his resting place is close. Wiping her eyes yet again, she struggles to focus ahead. Why was there a large crowd already at the gate? Surely most of the town was with her. Who were these visitors? She reaches the city gate and gazes up at the man who stands in front of the large multitude as she passes. She stops abruptly and her eyes connect with a man. The love and compassion on his face leaves her breathless. She feels drawn to this man. She feels he understands her pain. The woman clutches her chest as he walks towards her. He looks away from her to the bier where her beloved son lays. The man with the gentle eyes gets close and touches her shoulder. "Please do not weep." And when he spoke, her heart melted. The softness and compassionate tone of his voice astounds her. He is a stranger, yet he seems to feel her pain. How is that possible? The words seem to penetrate the depths of her heart. Suddenly, an unexplainable peace washes over her and she exhales. She hadn't realized that she was holding her breath. Slowly, the man walks over to the bier and motions for the bearers to stop. The procession comes to a standstill and the large crowd freezes, waiting, listening. The man leans over and touches the bier. "Young man, I say to you, rise." His potent voice rings out and reverberates around them. The woman's eyes round in shock and fear, expectantly.
Luke 7, 15 and 16. The dead man sat up and began to talk, and Jesus gave him back to his mother. They were all filled with awe and praised God. "A great prophet has appeared among us," they say. "God has come to help his people."
I love this story. It's actually only mentioned once in the Bible, and it's actually a really short story, but I love it. It is really powerful.
And this story is actually God's using his mouth to bring life, something we can definitely learn from, like from Jesus using his mouth to bring life.
Mm-hmm.
But let's talk about that when we come back from this song, Michael W. Smith with Ancient Words.
Open hearts, oh, let the ancient words impart.
girls, this month we have been looking at lips and how our mouths can be used to bring life or to damage others. You know, we've seen Delilah and her lying lips, the debt collector's angry lips, Miriam's gossiping lips, and today we are finishing the beautiful and lovely positive lips of Jesus.
Jesus, the lips of life, we call them. So everything that came out from his mouth brought life and was a blessing. You know, he didn't say much to the widow of Nain, the one that we read, that Steph read for you, but he said everything and he changed her life forever with the little that he said. So as God's girls, we need to learn to use our lips to bring life to other people, to other girls, to other women. And our lips have to encourage and our lips have to show love.
So girls, you can bring words to encouragement to others. In Ephesians 4:29, it says, "Let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them."
You know, our world at the moment is so dark and so depressing that it will be lovely if you can think, and all of us can use our lips to bring life, a little bit of compassion, a little bit of encouragement to someone's life. All we need to do is say something nice.
Mm-hmm. Tell someone that they're doing a great job or compliment them on something they've done or are doing, you know. You can bring life to others' life, mm-hmm. and they can be better off because of it. And so will you, actually.
I agree. And, you know, bringing someone hope is so important. Sharing with them the love of Jesus is really important. I know that it might feel weird for you to talk about God, but if these people are discouraged, you can start talking and say, "Hey, can I pray for you?" Just like that. If somebody's feeling really discouraged and you want to tell them about God, just ask if you can pray for them. And then pray together and tell them how God has helped you in your life, like a personal testimony. This works not only for strangers, but also for your family members, that you can pray for them.
So girls, every time you want to speak and you aren't sure if the words are life, ask yourself these questions.
All right. So one of the questions you can ask yourself is, are my words true? No lies will come out, even if it's a white lie.
Are my words loving? Will they help someone and lift them up with love, or will they destroy them?
Are my words encouraging? Will people walk away feeling full in their heart after what I tell them?
So girls, it's a great checklist to have, and you'll easily be able to know if what you're saying is the good or the bad.
So it's, are my words true? Are my words loving? Are my words encouraging? We can make a difference in someone's life by thinking before we speak and asking ourselves. I know that sometimes people think this is cheesy, but I think it's a great example if we say, you know, if Jesus was about to say this, would he say it? It's like a check-in.
It is.
And we can say, yeah, no. So if it's not good for him to say it, you know, it wouldn't be good for us to say
as
it
well.
Either.
Yeah. So girls, you know, God shows us and offers us words of comfort, love, encouragement, and hope. And we can also speak these words into others' life. You know, you don't have to use fancy words or, you know, tricky, eloquent words. Just heartfelt and uplifting, which is what God wants.
And just show others what love really is. So we hope that this month that your lips can be beautiful lips and anything you're struggling with can go to Jesus and he can help you. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for the end of the month. Thank you that we have learned so much about how you want us to be and how you want us to be godly women. I ask that you bless our beautiful girls who are listening to this and you help them as they try every day to have beautiful lips. Thank you, Lord, that we can bring it at your feet and we can leave it there and you can help us and encourage us to be better women. Also, I ask that you bless our family, protect us all under your wings, and give us a blessed day. In your name I ask, amen.
This has been Gigi Radio signing out.